Behind me are endless fields of green orchards. Clearly, here in the Central Valley, the agricultural landscape is getting plenty of water. But then, over here, you have the landscape for what the rest of California looks like for the most part, incredibly brown and dry because of the drought. They get no water.
This is the dichotomy of the Central Valley, big booming industry versus small minority communities. California's farmlands produce almost half of America's vegetables, fruits, and nuts, consuming 80% of the state's developed water in the process. The people most affected by the drought are those who live along the farm belt. Chris Kapheim, who manages the Alta Irrigation District, says rural communities get fewer resources for water than big cities like Los Angeles.
We have about 17,000 people living in disadvantaged communities on the east side, very impoverished areas. And when they run out of water, a lot of times they can't replace their wells. And so they have to put a tank there and just try to survive through these dry periods. And it's a significant hardship, you know, on those areas.
The Central Valley is filled with farmlands that drink up all of the water that local communities need to keep themselves up and running. So people who live in places like Kern County and also in Tulare County are having a lot of problems with contamination in the water.
Because of the drought, there isn't enough water to dilute or flush out contaminants like arsenic, nitrate, uranium, and pesticides. None are visible to the naked eye, and because the pumps are not regulated for contamination, these small, predominantly Latino communities are disproportionately affected by unsafe drinking water.
You know, the unfortunate thing, even when people have groundwater, they can't use it for their purposes in all cases because of the fact it's contaminated. You get in these dry periods, and it gets stressed, and then we see an enhancement of those impacts from the contamination.
In Tulare County, drinking water has elevated levels of nitrate from fertilizer runoff and the unregulated storage and disposal of animal waste. The International Agency for Research on Cancer labels nitrates as a carcinogen to humans. Nitrates have caused rashes in those who have showered or bathed in contaminated water, and it has also been linked to causing different types of cancers, thyroid issues, reproductive complications, and even blood disorders when consumed. Last year, the State Water Resources Board issued this warning. Do not give water to infants. Infants below the age of 6 months who drink water containing nitrate may quickly become seriously ill and, if untreated, may die because nitrate levels can interfere with the capacity of the infant's blood to carry oxygen.
I've been walking around the neighborhoods here in Tulare today where
the groundwater has been toxic enough to kill infants under 6 months old.
And this happens to infants just within a matter of days. As you can see behind me, children are playing in a swimming pool filled with this contaminated water, mainly because there are no alternative sources for groundwater here in Tulare.
Water districts on the east side are now banding together to make sure communities like Tulare are protected.
We're working to create a drinking water authority so that we can have an alternate supply and get those disadvantaged communities off groundwater. That's our long-term solution.
Legislation has also been introduced to put water solutions in place for cities, communities, and industry in order to balance what little water is available. SB 37 will knit together 15 local agencies, including Fresno and Tulare counties, agriculture and drinking water districts, to form a new groundwater agency on the east side.
The reason that we put these different entities together in this bill is to bring the cities, all the people that have the different types of impacts. Agriculture has their impacts. They'll be at the table. The cities, they want their water for people in the cities. You have the disadvantaged communities, these small drinking water districts. They have their particular issues. And I think we want to make sure we're sensitive and addressing all the different issues and so that we can be successful in moving this process forward.
To the south in Kern County's Arvin, the water supply is heavily contaminated with arsenic. Arsenic, which is naturally present in rocks and soil, can also be leached into groundwater from local mining operations.
Here, I'm in Kern County. Now, this is the heartland in California where all of the oil and gas drilling operations take place. And unfortunately, these operations are damaging groundwater supplies. In fact, one in six of these operations happens directly on top of a freshwater supply.
Jerry Tinoco, who was born in Arvin, says he earned an environmental science degree from the University of California, Berkeley, so he could help secure safe drinking water for his hometown. He now focuses on raising awareness about a rarely talked about carcinogen known as 1,2,3-trichloropropane. TCP has been linked to cancers of the stomach, kidney, liver, and pancreas, and is currently present in more than 200 valley wells at levels up to 200 times higher than recommended.
It was a byproduct and a couple of pesticides used in the 20th century, manufactured by Dow and Shell. Now, these contaminants were not the primary ingredient in this fumigant that was used to, you know, kill nematodes in the soil. It was just a byproduct that was left in the final product and was not made aware to the farmers. So farmers applied this fumigant all throughout the Central Valley, not knowing what they were doing. And now, years later, it's coming up in people's groundwater.
To date, no cleanup efforts have been made, and no laws require water boards or providers to test, regulate, or treat water laced with TCP.
We're trying to urge the State Water Board to finally put an MCL, which is called a maximum contaminant level, which is the legal limit at which a contaminant can be in the water. For example, arsenic is 10 parts per billion. So anything above that, it's deemed unsafe. Here in Arvin, we have levels from 26 to over 30 parts per billion. But there exists no such limit for 1-3 TCP, even though it's been a known carcinogen for almost 20 years.
So far, Tinoco has helped the Arvin Community Water Center install arsenic water filters on drinking fountains in the area, as well as filtered water vending stations. But there's no way to remove TCP on a consumer level. Arvin is now in cost recovery litigation with Dow and Shell, which the city is awaiting a ruling on.
Resources don't make their way out here. Farm working communities are often overlooked, and it's important to have, you know, a seat at the table or just not be forgotten.
In 2013, California became the first state to declare water a basic human right, a right that is currently being denied to over 1 million people, most of whom live in the rural areas of the San Joaquin Valley. Reporting from the San Joaquin Valley, Brigida Santos, RT.